children that are being abused, depends on the age, you know, because there are some pedophiles around, and some of them could be family members, as fathers and brothers, uncles, you know. Doesn't matter, it could be women too, you know, that abuse maybe young boys or whatever. And that is the time that we are living in, you know. And most of these children, you know, they are being threatened. See, maybe they might tell them, if they tell anybody, what they're going to do to them and all this kind of stuff. You know, and these people that, you know, you know, God have mercy upon them, you know. And that's why I'm saying that is a problem we have in this society that we live in right now. You know, so where people, you know, pick out, you know, and zero in on young children, you know, that can't do much for themselves and take advantage of them. You know, these people, you know, God is going to deal with them. You know, God is going to deal with them. And to any child, you know, that's of age, you know, and can say something, you know, I would advise them to speak to somebody, you know, because there are people that maybe you could speak to. You could find somebody, you know, that is that you have confidence in, you know, that could advise you, you know, and take it to maybe the authorities, you know, and bring that person to justice. Because I believe if a man or a woman could do that to a young child, that person is eligible, you know, that's what I'm saying, for the authorities to be thrown into jail. You know, I don't compromise when it comes to these things. That's the law is for the lawless. Amen. And likewise, even them too, likewise, they can get, you know, they could take heed of the ways and repent of the sins likewise and allow God, you know, to come into them, amen, by the way of repentance. Glory be to God, and water baptism, and that they themselves could receive forgiveness for their wrongdoings, you know. But I'm saying that in this time that we are living, it is just a matter of people just taking advantage on. It's a very ticklish, you know, topic, you know, especially those, you know, you know that they themselves are abusing people, you know, and they use them. Sometimes they use money, they use all kind of methods so that they could keep these people quiet. These people are wicked people. Glory be to God. Amen. And I'm saying that is why I am there. That is why those that call themselves children of God are there. That's why those that call themselves pastors and ministers, you know, evangelists, that is why they are there. Amen. To go out into the communities, to go, amen, and preach the word, amen. Because that's how they're going to get saved. Both those that are the pedophiles and those that abusing people, likewise, that they themselves could come to God, amen, before it's everlastingly too late. I don't think anybody, amen, that in their right mind, praise the Lord, would want to see a child get it, because I know of a lot of cases, praise the name of the Lord, I know of a lot of cases, you know, and it's not much, you understand what I'm saying, that could be done about it. Depends on what environment that they're living in, you know. And I'm saying today, we have that opportunity, amen, to go out and to speak to men, speak to women, amen, speak to boys, speak to girls, praise the name of the Lord, that they themselves, hallelujah, could be saved from this perverse world, amen, and to come unto Christ, praise the name of the Lord, which is ever living and ever faithful, bless the name of the Lord, amen. So it is there for each and every one of them. Those that are being abused and those that are doing it, praise the name of the Lord, could come to God, amen, by the way of repentance and water baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, and they shall receive the Spirit of the Holy Ghost. They shall be saved. They can be saved in Jesus' name. Amen.